The Frame 92.5 FM.
Hey, welcome in, guys, along for the ride. Today's new drug is a gorgeous day at Hidden Hills, where we had the Guggen and had a blast playing golf out here. We sure appreciate our friends from Hidden Hills, Russ Libby and company, always inviting us out, and so many of our clients and friends of this radio station that were out here today having a big time. I mean, Hayes, spectacular weather today.
Yeah, absolutely. You couldn't have drawn it up. I mean, really, the last 3 days has been unbelievable. And, so how'd you play? I've heard some good things. I've heard some bad things.
I've been playing really well. I mean, I'm shooting 80, 82, 83 a lot. I can't putt. I know that's news breaking that I still can't make a putt. I'll bet I missed today. I played with my friend Jamie Shelton for the best bet, Alex Ricker Gilbert from JU. I'll bet I missed 7 6-footers.
Wow.
Now 6-footers aren't automatic. They're not kick-ins or 2-footers.
Yeah.
But I'll bet I missed 7 6-footers and shot 83. Should have shot 78, 79, something good. But it's a, played well Saturday.
I've got a solution.
Please.
Mallet putter.
Okay. I thought you were going to say putt better. Okay, so that would be one solution. Maybe it is the equipment. Listen, I'm not afraid to blame the equipment rather than blame me. I'm all about that. But it's a wonderful day today. Our Jack O'Brien from our staff works really hard to put this thing on, and it's important to him, and he cares, and he does a wonderful job. And our shows are all out here, and it's just a wonderful day for our radio station. It really is. And when the weather cooperates like this, it was really fantastic. So thanks to all the clients who not only were out here today, but spend so much time supporting us. They're why we're here. Your listeners are why we're here, and clients who support us are why we're here. And today's the day to celebrate that. So we were able to celebrate. It was just a
how many years is this for the Guggen?
I should know that. 17?
15?
It's 15 maybe.
Because it's 17,
it's 17
for the
radio station.
Yeah.
It's got to be around 15. Okay. Same on me for not knowing that, but I will.
It started kind of a couple years in.
Jacko's behind us giving away. He's still giving away.
It's amazing.
Is there anything better when Jack grabs that mic? Forget
mic.
About it, okay?
Yeah.
When he gets the mic, settle in, buddy, okay? Because it's going to be a show. Jacko gets that mic. He is locked in. Yeah. You know what that is? I call that entertainment.
That's right.
So the
ringmaster.
So he's certainly all kind of things to get to. I know you were at the Orange and Blue game. I got a lot of thoughts on that. I want to get your full report from being there live. So we'll certainly talk about that. Also want to thank the folks from Spurrier's, Florida Victorious, which sponsored us. What a fun Friday!
Yeah.
Friday the ball coach came by and it was fun having him on. And then Todd Golden just happened to be by, so we snatched him.
Yeah.
And we dragged him in and had him do a little radio too. So.
And then he got a commitment.
Right after the big power forward, Sam
Alexis.
Sam Alexis, that's exactly right. So we'll talk some college football coming up. Talk some Gators, talk all kind of stuff. We are inside of 2 weeks from the draft. We'll have a draft luncheon, a media luncheon with both Doug and Trent later in the week, Thursday, I believe it is. So we'll get an idea of kind of what they're thinking. Actually, we won't because nobody in that setting would tell you what they're thinking. But it'll be good to hear from them where their head is going into the draft. Tom Gamble, a new employee, I guess, the Jags have hired in the front office under Trent Baalke.
Correct. He'll be one of Trent's lieutenants, if not his top one. And, Ethan Waugh's done a nice job, too.
Yeah, so, and very well – both were very well respected.
So, beefing up that front office, and, that's a good thing. Baalke and Gamble have done some good things together in San Francisco.
Yeah, so all that coming up. So we'll get to some college football, some pro football, all kind of fun stuff. Beautiful day today. We'll talk a little golf, and gosh, we had a great time, a truly great time out here at the Guggen, so we surely appreciate all that contributed. Speaking of golf, there was a golf tournament over the weekend. Did you hear?
Whew. Not a lot of drama in that one.
Listen, I said this last week, if he won again, it's hard to dominate. It's really hard to dominate these great fields of this era of golf.
And in these conditions in Augusta National.
Correct.
Might have been the toughest it's ever played, at least in 20, 25 years. And the cut was 6 over.
Correct. And, Hayes, it's really hard to dominate when you're the one everybody expects to dominate. What Scottie Scheffler is doing, and Lee Smith, our golf analyst from the Players' Championship, will be with us on Thursday, as he always is. He's forgotten more about golf than I'll ever know. I'll defer to him. But I don't know that I agree with him. This is the most Tiger-like performance since Tiger. I'm not saying it's anywhere near Tiger, but it is the most Tiger-like performance since Tiger. I mean, this guy is just taking these really, really, really good golfers out back every time. I mean, he took the drama out of that thing from about 4 o'clock on. 2 o'clock on.
Right.
Pretty amazing stuff.
What I find so striking about Scottie Scheffler is he never has to scramble.
Right.
I mean, at all. He just is in such command from tee to green. And his putter at sometimes is, I'd say, average. But when you never get yourself off track, it's incredible. And obviously, in about a 15-minute window, the other contenders all fell apart. Homa, Morikawa, Oberg all had moments of catastrophe. And Scottie Scheffler just kept right on going. I mean, he had a couple bogeys, but again, in those conditions, that's going to happen. But he made up for it with putting up a round that was tied for the second best on Sunday. I mean, we've seen certainly guys win majors in a flurry. We've seen that. Morikawa's a two-time major champion. Brooks Koepka obviously has done very well at the U.S. Open and the PGA. We've seen it. But this feels different because there's a fire to him, but he plays with such stoicism that he just doesn't have a weakness right now. And again, we golf is so unpredictable. And we talked about, you know, Brendel Chamblee going into the Masters was like, what's my prediction for the Masters? If Scottie Scheffler putts great, he'll win by six. If he putts, you know, so-so, he'll win by four. If he doesn't putt well, he'll win by two. And if he's injured, he'll win by one.
Right.
And that's exactly basically
how it won by four.
How it played out.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
I mean,
he's the most, how do I phrase this? He's the most expected to win and still wins guy since Tiger. Did I say that right?
Yeah. Well,
he's a guy. How hard is it to win when everybody expects you to win? You are the odds-on pick to win, and then you go ahead and win anyway. That was Tiger. Tiger would go into these tournaments. Everybody picked Tiger to win, and you'd think at some point he can't win every time, and he would still keep winning, yeah. And that's what this is. This is amazing. And by the way,
he's yet to have a round over par.
I know, which is amazing
on the season.
And think about that. He's not been over par on the season, and those of us that play a lot of golf, I mean, most people, a lot of men play golf. I mean, a lot of us are avid golfers. One thing any avid golfer will tell you, I don't care if you're a 15 handicap, an 11 handicap, a scratch player, a plus player, one thing I think most golfers will tell you, shot making is not as important as consistency. Repeating the good shot is more important than occasionally making the great shot. It is.
Yeah.
And in that regard, he's as good as we've seen. I promise you, in that regard, he's as good as we've seen since vintage Tiger. He hits it down the middle every time. He hits greens. He makes putts. Now he's made some reckless shots. Obviously, the eagle yesterday changed everything. He's chipped in, but this guy makes more of the routine stuff better than anybody we've seen in a long time. It's honest to God, it's amazing to watch.
Yeah, I mean, he's the player of the year, and here we are in April with still three majors to play. And the FedEx Cup, but you can etch it in stone that he's going to be the player of the year this year. I mean, he's already got the Players and the Masters, and the way he's going, I mean, he's going to be such a dominant. The bookmakers are going to have to make him such a dominant favorite in the PGA because they're going to lose. I mean, they're going to get killed. Obviously, he was an overwhelming favorite to win the Masters, and he did it. The public is going to be all over him now moving forward. So you're going to see, I think, going into the PGA, some historic odds in terms of Scheffler, Tiger-esque odds going into that. So we've seen guys pop up and have great runs, but what he's done is incredible. And to have two players and two Masters and still have three more majors this year where he's obviously playing light years better than anybody else, it could be really a historic year for Scottie Scheffler.
And I will say this, and this is a me thing, not a I expect from anybody else thing. But I really like who he is, and I love how unabashed way he talked about his spirituality. I really like that. Tebow did, Charlie Ward did, Danny Werfel did, many others did too. But and part of it's I share spirituality with him. But beyond that, I like the way that the very matter-of-fact way. He's not preaching to anybody. He's not pounding a pulpit. He just very calmly says, here's what works for me. and I like that. And I like him.
How could you not?
I saw someone tweet, is he the greatest athlete going that has no haters? Isn't that right?
Yeah, I mean,
nobody hates him.
Unless you just want to see somebody else win, which right, that I
right.
get.
Well, that's but not hating. That's correct. Just rooting for, that's rooting just, for the underdog.
Correct.
Yeah.
But in terms, other than just the dominant fatigue of him, from a personality standpoint, because, again, he's gotten criticized for there not being a lot of sizzle there.
Yeah.
But I think there's definitely a fire. I mean, you saw it when his mission was complete yesterday and he'd finished off the 18th. I mean, you saw for it not being a very dramatic conclusion – I mean, you saw the emotion come out in him. So, I mean, you know, it's a really cool story. He's getting ready to start a family. I mean, he's a great, you know, a American athlete. And, you know, it's going to be fun to see. Eventually somebody's going to step up, and it'll be fascinating to see who it is. But for right now, I mean, they've got three more majors in the FedEx Cup. It's hard for me to believe he's not going to win at least two of those four final prizes.
He's 27, looks about 36, doesn't he?
He does look older.
He does not look like one of these kids. The kids usually look like the kids. He looks way older than that. But that's today's great golfer. It's a guy that is about that age.
And what's so amazing is I remember like the trio that was coming up, and it was Morikawa, Hovland, and I want to say who was the third? Fitzpatrick, maybe. There was I don't think it was Matthew Fitzpatrick, but there was a third guy in the group that really hasn't done a whole lot. Obviously, Hovland and Morikawa have lived up to it.
Right.
Morikawa, like we said, has won two majors, and Hovland had a fantastic year last year. But Scottie Scheffler has just, I mean, blown past them. I mean, again, for being 27, I mean, he could have 10 more spectacular years of this.
Yeah.
He doesn't strike me as somebody that's going to go fiddle with his swing. He certainly doesn't strike me as somebody that's going to start trying to bench press 500 pounds.
Right.
And sustain a bunch of injuries. I don't think he's going to go – nothing. There's anything wrong with this, but I don't think he's going to go, you know, thrill seek and go train with Navy SEALs.
Right, right.
So, I mean, if he is able to have 10 healthy years of golf ahead of him, I mean, it's just hard to see anything getting in his way of great consequence.
Yeah.
You know, and obviously there's a lot of great players, but I mean, if you win one event a year, I mean, if he were to win one big event a year for the next 10 years and then maybe win, you know, a couple more after the age of 37, which is certainly possible.
Right.
I mean, he's going to have one of the best careers we've ever seen.
Yeah, and one thing we are seeing now, and we'll see how it goes, is that we lock ourselves into this. The prime age for the golfer now is 25 to 32, 33. We forget, and Max Homa's 33 years old. He's not a kid. Tommy Fleetwood's 32 years old. You know, we think I think of those guys as kids.
Yeah.
But they're not. They're in their 30s.
But even then, I mean, Mickelson didn't win a major until he was 33. And
right.
Obviously ended up winning several. So, right. I mean, it really is interesting to see how far he can take this. It is a fickle sport. Maybe something happens and it sets him back, but it seems like he would have everything that you would need to really have a sustained run of consistent excellence. And again, it's impossible to do better than what he's doing right now, because he's winning tournaments, and a lot of these tournaments he's winning aren't overly close. The Players was close. The Players an incredible finish where he could have easily – he was a millimeter away from being in a playoff with Wyndham Clark. But, I mean, yesterday was just – I mean, he just dissected the field.
Yeah, he really did. Other things. And, by the way, Loser Monday, I'm not happy about this.
Ooh,
I'm
yeah.
buying your two losers. By the way, how bad – first of all, yeah. I'll admit that I'm buying to you two losers.
Right.
But how bad did J.J. LaSelva –
crush us.
Out of Ocala Vanguard, played for the Vikings there. How bad did he just wear us out?
Yeah.
Just to the woodshed.
Oh, yeah, because his last pick in the draft destroyed our guys.
Cam Smith and Scheffler, so I think they were both in the top 10.
Yeah, Scheffler you get no credit for, obviously.
Right.
But Cam Smith, I will definitely tip my hat
but
for
But he
you
beat
for
us
that.
By like 30 strokes.
Oh, by a million.
So the two savvy veteran losing – the two loser Monday savvy veterans might have made the two worst picks in the tournament.
Oh, it was brutal.
So, and which does beg this question.
I was cheering during the broadcast.
Yeah, I was too.
And obviously, really, yeah, they only showed our guys when they were like finishing.
Right, right.
But 3 o'clock, CBS starts it.
Right.
The first thing they show is Hideki Matsuyama draining a birdie putt. And I'm like, oh, great. Here we go.
Yeah.
And, you know, and, but I mean, really, other than that, between Rahm, Matsuyama, Rory, and Koepka.
Right.
I think of those four players on Sunday's CBS broadcast, they showed 5 shots.
Yeah.
Because they showed all four of them finishing.
Well, how close
and
was
I
it
think they showed a Rory or
I think,
a couple shots.
Three shots,
Okay.
But what I saw it differently. I would, for whatever reason, whether I was looking at a leaderboard or something, I would always see Rory or Koepka first. And I'd see Koepka 7-under, 8-over, 9-over. And I would laugh hysterically at you until one moment later – they show Rahm at 10-over or whatever he was. So I mean, my joy didn't last long.
Right.
My mocking joy didn't last very long.
This is one that, like, this is my perspective on this. This is like walking off the football field and you won a game 7-6.
That's exactly right.
And you're like, thank God we won, but boy, did we play
badly.
You
turned it over 5 times.
Yeah,
but somehow.
Right.
But off Loser Monday, it does pose this question. What has happened to Jon Rahm? Jon Rahm, a year ago, felt like the best player in the world.
Absolutely.
And so, I mean, the best player in the world, is that what LIV does to you?
I think so.
Because, I mean, he was – I mean, Koepka could be up and down. Rory was fading because he's not at LIV. But, I mean, DeChambeau might have been what they said.
Kind Look of, at Dustin Johnson.
I mean, and he was getting a little older.
He's 13 over.
Right. But he – but Rahm is the one.
Yeah.
Jon Rahm – bro, he was the best player. I'm not sure. I would have picked him over Scheffler as the best player in the world as recently as a year ago.
Yeah.
No, I mean, I really
I think most people would have.
Yeah, and how did he go from best player in the world, or certainly in the conversation among two or three best players in the world? He's terrible. How did Jon Rahm become terrible? If you want case study number one of how LIV ruins you,
right.
Jon Rahm is the case study.
Well, to be fair, I mean, he finished 2nd in the Open last year.
Yeah, he did.
But then he joined LIV after.
But LIV was after that.
Yeah,
he joined. He joined LIV very late.
Yeah.
And because I think he even competed in the FedEx Cup. So he's a recent add to LIV. I don't think being on LIV has disrupted him as much as I think he has incredible buyer's remorse for going.
Right.
Because, I mean, again, you're talking about somebody that already was a multi-millionaire.
Yeah.
So, yes, he got a ton of money to go to LIV, but I don't think his lifestyle has greatly changed going from being a dominant player on the PGA Tour financially to going to LIV and, you know, in terms of the quality of his life. But I think Jon Rahm joined LIV because he was like, I'm going to cash the check and they're getting ready to merge. And I'm going to get a huge payday, and I'm going to be able to come right back
because
they're going to merge.
I believe
and then
that.
The merge fell through
because
I mean he was talking even before the tournament about complaints that he has on LIV, and I think it's just something that he's allowed it to seep into his game. You know, I mean those guys look ridiculous wearing their LIV logos out there, and I think it's all of it. I don't think he likes. I just don't think he likes the association that he has chosen. And I do think it's affecting his golf game.
Yeah.
So I think with Dustin Johnson, with Bubba Watson, guys that really embarrassed themselves this weekend, I think that is they've been on LIV now for like 2 or 3 years. And I do think the lack of consistent, competitive PGA Tour, I think that's hurt their games.
Yeah.
With Rahm, I don't think that it's that he's been on LIV for any great length of time. I think that mentally he's in the jar over his decision.
Well, and I can tell you, and that's a great take, and maybe that's it. I can tell you this. So my buddy Jamie Shelton today. Jamie, the president of the Best Bet, great guy, one of my dear friends in the world. He went down to Doral 2 years ago, or 2 weeks ago, just to watch because he'd heard about the LIV, so he went down with some buddies, and they all went down. And they went to the tournament. He said the good thing about the tournament was it was kind of fun for the fans because you'd walk right next to Mickelson. One group, one time it was Mickelson, Rahm, and DJ was in the group. That's a pretty good group. And you walk next to them. I mean, you're 5 feet away from them. Walking, they're in shorts. They're playing music on every TV. Do you know that? They play the music. They're playing Journey, and they're playing rock music, Bon Jovi on the tee box, right. And you're wearing shorts, and you're casual. And he said it was a wonderful experience. I said, was anybody? He said, nobody went. He said, there's nobody there.
Yeah.
Nobody watching on TV. Nobody attending. Some of the best players in the history in the world of in recent memory are there in a pair of shorts, laughing and joking with you. It feels like amateur or
right.
exhibition
a
golf.
Pro-am or yeah, something.
Yeah,
yeah.
But so he told me that story, and now when I see what's happened to the whole iron sharpens iron thing, and when it's not there to sharpen you, the iron dulls. That's what's happened. Those guys no longer play competitive golf. They play exhibition golf. So there's no real competitive golf. There's not. So there, you're not having to grind out stuff.
Yeah.
It's like the pro.
Even with DeChambeau faded.
Right. It's like the pro who plays and the tour pro back in the day that would win at Hilton Head. Okay? And he would win, and it wasn't the most important tournament of the year, but everyone like, kind of likes Hilton Head and the fun time of year. And then because he's there, his best buddy from college is now the pro in Charleston at Isle of Palms. So after he wins Sunday at Hilton Head, he drives over to Charleston because he promised his buddy. They were roommates in college, and he promised his buddy he'd play in the pro-am even though he just won. And he probably comes out there in shorts, and he kind of knocks it around, and he's kind of paying attention. And, you know, he may be with some members and tries to show off a little bit, but it's not that big a deal, too, right? Well, if that's all you do, if you didn't have the 4 days at Hilton Head before going and knocking around with your buddy because he's the club pro in Charleston, if going to play with the club pro in Charleston is all you did, then you wouldn't be able to do the 4 days.
Yeah.
And that's what it is. All they do is take batting practice. If all you do is take batting practice and you're never in a game, it's going to be hard to hit in a game. I think John Rahm and listen, I know Cam Smith played great and he was in it. Bryson DeChambeau, after the great start, hung around for a while. I'm not saying there weren't live golfers. Patrick Reed was only one.
Hatton.
He plays that course well. Correct. There's a handful of live golfers that were in play. I know that. But
there was a lot of really miserable rounds.
And I think John Rahm is an example of if all you're doing is taking batting practice and all you're doing is playing in exhibitions, when you get into the game, it's hard. And I really think with Rahm, that's what you're seeing.
Yeah, and again, we'll see. I mean, there's obviously we still have three majors left. We'll see, you know, if Liv fares a little bit better. But, yeah, I've thought from the beginning it was going to be a failure because there's just you need to be playing for something with tradition in golf. You can't just invent something and say – this is now a really big deal. I just don't think the public gravitates to that. The PGA Tour and the major championship schedule, it has so much tradition, so much integrity, and I just think the LIV Tour is soulless golf. I just don't think it has a lot of appeal to the fans. I understand financially why players went over there to play, but when they did that, they had to know that they were sacrificing a lot of fame because no one's going to watch them now. And they were sacrificing, I think, the ability to stay super sharp. We'll see how it continues to play out. But I think the longer those players are on the LIV Tour, the less amount of impact they're going to make in the major championships.
It's hard to argue that. It's hard to make a logical argument against that point. We'll take a break. We're live here at Hidden Hills. Glad you're with us for the program. It is always a Best Bet Monday. I played golf with my buddy Jamie Shelton today, the president of the Best Bet. Always good to catch up with him. And we sure do appreciate our friends from the Best Bet. Friday and Saturday, by the way, $1,500 high hands. Every 30 minutes, that's at the Best Bet Jacksonville over here on Monument Road near where we are. Orange Park on 17 and in St. Augustine. That is from noon until midnight, Friday and Saturday, $1,500 high hands. That's at the Best Bet, always a Best Bet Monday around here. When we come back, were you in Gainesville Saturday?
I was.
Did you go to a ball game?
It was.
Orange and blue?
We had a blast.
They don't call it the debut anymore, do they?
Thank God.
That was so dumb.
I never liked that.
It was
that.
So dumb. So,
yeah, no, it was good.
You saw the orange and blue game. You saw the spring game. I watched it on TV.
But I'm predicting 15-0.
Yeah, you've got a firsthand report. We'll talk some Gator football after this. Stay with us.
The Frangie Show from the Harrell & Harrell Studio. Don't settle for less than you deserve.
Here's another look behind the microphone at 1010XL with Dan Hicken and Jeff Prosser.
You can't just walk in off the street and do what we do. It takes years and years of training. I mean, let's just let them perform a tracheotomy while we're at it.
Mornings on 1010XL.
This is ridiculous.
This is Hayes Carline for QC Kinetics. The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in the most exciting, revolutionary pain management that we've seen in decades. Regenerative medicine. If you were tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics right now. They've got two great locations in the Jacksonville area, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. Call them for a free consultation at 904-274-5522. They have availabilities. You can get in, go see them this week. Again, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. QC Kinetics is leading the field in this work. No downtime, no surgery for that pain in your hips, your shoulders, your knees. This is a solution for you. We're talking natural biologics using your body's own power. Give them a call today, 904-274-5522 in Mandarin and Ponte Vedra Beach. That's QC Kinetics.
I'm Holt Harrell with Harrell & Harrell. Choosing a law firm after an accident is an important decision. With so many messages, we know it can all sound the same. At Harrell & Harrell, we believe what sets us apart is our commitment to you. We'll help you find doctors to get you better, and we'll work hard to maximize any recovery. Visit our website and look at our reviews to see how we've helped people just like you make this important decision. Harrell & Harrell. Offices, Jacksonville.
Big Chief Tire guarantees quality service at every visit. Frank Brangi here. Right now, take $50 off a new set of tires to stay worry-free on the road. Plus, with Big Chief's Tire Protection Plan, you can enjoy free tire repairs and replacements for up to 3 years. Don't let worn-out tires slow you down. Stop by Big Chief and experience the difference today. Visit BigChiefTire.com or call 904-932-0950 to schedule an appointment for one of their five locations. Big Chief Tire. Keeps Jacks rolling.
If you're a business owner and want to learn about federal, state, or local government contracts, plan to attend a free online webinar April 23rd. The Florida Apex Accelerator, in partnership with UNF, provides expert guidance and consultations at no cost. The Apex Accelerator program can make selling to the government less complicated. To attend the free coffee and contracting webinar April 23rd, register at unf.edu/sbdc. Then select Training and Event tab.
Make sure your roof is ready for the next Florida storm by scheduling a complimentary roof inspection with Universal Roof and Contracting. And right now, get $200 off your roof repair and $500 off a roof replacement, plus no interest for 1 year. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Ensure peace of mind before the next storm hits with Universal Roof and Contracting. License number CCC057165, CBC125-8484.
Universal Roof.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free from credit cards, car loans, and personal loans. Hey, Prosser here. Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make it happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards. Get some money for a home improvement. Literally hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508. 904-999-1508, or go to loanpronto.com. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
Mia O'Brien.
Fun-loving girl.
On Helmets and Heels from noon to two.
Likes to laugh, lives to love. No dull moments tolerated.
Mia's quick hits are driven by Arlington Toyota. On the video and social channels of 1010XL. Nobody gets in the war room, but 1010XL will get you close.
That's good. That's very good.
1010XL's draft coverage is brought to you by Renewal by Anderson Windows and Doors. Proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
If you're an experienced, skilled plumber or welder that's MedGas certified and you're tired of working for a company that just doesn't treat you right, Local 234 is the place for you. Their pay is the best in the business. You'll walk away with $35.09 an hour in your pocket with benefits that's just over $50 an hour. Local 234 has been around since 1901, and that means something. Visit UA234.com to send your resume. Local 234, make the right connection.
Hey, everybody, it's Mike Dempsey. Look, before starting Awaken 180, I first wanted to ensure I keep the weight off after dropping it. Well, Paige explained the process, and I was in. Here's Paige now to share it with you.
And through this process of cooking your food, through eating out at restaurants, through ordering alcoholic beverages, which you can drink with Awaken 180 with our guidance, you're learning these tools, you're educating yourself, and it doesn't even seem like learning, but you'll learn so much about the foods that you're eating and the variety that you can enjoy that you are arming yourself and ultimately your family with a whole host of information that will enable you to make the right choices, the best choices, the choices that taste good to you long-term so that you can experience that long-term success easily.
Thanks, Paige. I chose Awaken 180 because I wanted a solution, a way not to only lose the weight, but the ability to maintain it for life. I found it with Awaken 180. So what's stopping you? Online at awaken180weightloss.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
It's a Best Bet Monday on The Frangie Show with fantastic locations in Jacksonville, Orange Park, and now in St. Augustine. It's Best Bet.
Yeah, I mean, I think we threw it to the other team a couple times. We'd like to have those back, but overall, when given opportunity, I thought we took advantage of it. You know, I do think that those guys have been awesome. I mean, I can't compliment those two guys enough.
Billy Napier, after the game, the two guys he's talking about are Graham Mertz and DJ Lagway, the two quarterbacks. Frank Frangie, Hayes Carline with you. JJ LaSelva back at World Headquarters. Hayes, you were there. I got a lot of thoughts that I – and by the way, I didn't go. I played golf. Sorry. Lazy guy. Beautiful day for golf, in case you're wondering. But I know you were at the spring game. What is nice now is you can with ESPN Plus, they're all on demand.
Right.
So you go back, put it up on your big screen, and watch the entire game. And I did that. So a number of things stood out to me, but you had a way better look. You were there. What jumped off the page for you? Give me kind of an overview of all your thoughts because I got a few too.
Yeah, and I haven't watched the TV tape yet, so I'm looking forward to doing that. So I'll be interested to get your vantage point. I'll say this. Being there, it was fantastic. They need to keep the orange and blue game on Saturdays.
I agree.
Moving forward, it was a great experience from a fan standpoint. I went with my dad and my son Jackson, and we had a blast.
Three generations of Carlines.
Three generations,
I mean, that was three generation
yeah.
Carlines, what happened in that
right.
car.
So we had a great time, and I thought, you know, they did a great job. The Florida Victorious thing was very cool. So, so kudos to all involved, and hopefully we can keep the spring game on Saturday at 1 o'clock. I thought from a physical standpoint, I'm impressed with them. I think their speed is better. I think they're bigger. So I see a roster that looks more like what a Florida roster should look like. I don't know that they're, you know, an A-plus yet by any stretch, but I see improvement, which I liked. And, look, I think you have to like the quarterbacks. I mean, I think you have to like what Mertz gives them. I was worried about Lagway because I just had heard some things about how his spring had gone, but I thought he was comfortable. I can see in terms of how he holds the ball so close to his body at times, how that could fundamentally lead to some issues for him. But I thought, you know, he moved the ball well. His, you know, teammates, it was fun watching him on the sideline and how he interacted with his teammates shows good leadership for a young player. And, Frank, they've got some running backs in that room that, I mean, I don't know how many carries they're going to get behind Montrell Johnson, but if something were to happen to Montrell Johnson, I think Florida's got a number of running backs that could be ready to make a big contribution. So I was impressed by what I saw. What'd you see?
I will tell you that, and again, I watched on TV, and you have to temper your enthusiasm. It's a spring game. So, you know, anytime your offense looks really good, is your offense good or does your defense suck? If your defense looks good, vice versa. So I've learned over all these years, temper your enthusiasm about a spring game because spring game can't really tell you. Spring game rarely tells you how good your football team is, at least this is my mind. But that doesn't mean guys can't catch your eye. I will tell you, number 13, Jaden Baugh, and I'm not a recruit in a case. You and I laugh about it because you do way better job than I do of following recruiting. I don't follow it very closely. I had no idea who he was.
Well, he was sort of a hidden gem.
Yeah.
He was not a five-star.
Yeah, yeah, and Jacoby Jackson, the other running back, too. 13 was Baugh, and 24 was Jackson. But 13, Jaden Baugh, I watched about three or four plays. When I watched it the first time, so I played golf. Okay, so here's my day. I played golf with a bunch of my buddies. Went home, hopped in the shower, Suzanne and I went to dinner. we had a nice dinner. So by the time I've come back, A, I've played golf in the sun. B, I've gone to dinner, all of which adds up to I've had a few. Okay, okay, okay. You with me? All right. So I've had a few. All right. Yeah. So I'm kind of half watching, and we're home from dinner 9:30. So I wanted to watch it, so I'm watching it, and I've had a few, and so I'm watching this guy 13, and I'm like, dang, that's pretty good, and I fall asleep because I'd had a few. So the next day, Sunday, I get up, watch the whole thing, and I'm like, I'll tell you, and I watched a little bit of it Saturday night. I got to watch more of it on Sunday. That's a pretty good player. There's some things Jaden Baugh, who I had never heard of, did that, again, there's a lot of spring superstars that never become anything in the fall, and I know that. But he had the look. He's 237 pounds.
That's the striking thing.
He's Derrick Henry size, and his feet were lightning quick. I thought he looked like he might be a really good player. The other running back, Jacoby Jackson, who I didn't know. Is he a JUCO guy, I think?
Yes.
He's another guy. Again, I don't follow it closely. So here's the big picture. I'm not ready to send Jaden Baugh to New York for the Heisman yet.
Right.
But what I do think is you get the impression there's a little more athleticism in the spots, in some spots where than there has been in the past. So I think two or three things, Hayes. Number one, the running backs, to your point, because I didn't know who that guy was. But two or three other things. I do think in college football, and this isn't new, you've heard me say this before, if you are good at quarterback and defensive line, I mean those two spots, quarterback and defensive line in college football, you have a chance to have a good football team. Now, I don't know how good Cam Jackson and Caleb Banks will be, but they've held off this Joey Slackman guy for a while. Tyreek Sapp is back for another year. The L.J. McCray guy that was the top recruit they really like.
Kelby Collins, I think, can have a big year.
So if they're good on the defense, if they're better, I shouldn't say good. Georgia's good. Alabama's good.
Right.
Florida State's good. If they're better on the defensive front, then they can have a decent team. They are going to be good at quarterback. When you're good, the one thing Florida has over some other teams is I think Graham Mertz might be really good this year. And he's a guy, you're bringing back your quarterback. A lot of the teams you play this year, a lot of them, LSU, FSU, Miami, teams of significance, are playing a different quarterback than they played last year. They may have a really good one. DJ Uiagalelei might be good. Cam Ward might be good. Garrett Nussmeier might be good. But there are a bunch of those teams are playing different quarterbacks than they played. So there's a chance you're going to out-quarterback those teams. And if you're good at quarterback and you're good on the defensive front, you can show growth. So, and the third component is overall team athleticism. If you wanted me to go 1, 2, 3, quarterback 1, defensive line 2, and overall team athleticism 3, and again, watching on television, not there in person, you do get the impression that those three areas will be improved.
Yeah, I think so as well. And, you know, again, the Jaden Baugh story was really interesting. He was an Arkansas commit until really late in the process. And then, then basically I think teams started to wise up to what he could be as a running back, because I think initially he was viewed as a linebacker. And kind of like Derrick Henry's story, he was adamant about, no, I'm a running back in college.
Right,
I'm not a linebacker. I'm a running back. That's where I want to play. And so, but his feet are exceptionally quick. I was stunned when I saw he was 237. And he sets up his blocks really well. He's got a good knowledge of, and I'm assuming this is more instinct than it is he knows the playbook,
right?
Because he just arrived. But he has a really good sense of where it's supposed to go and when it's supposed to get there. And I think he's a really exciting player. Obviously, Trey Wilson looks like he's going to be a superstar his sophomore year if they can keep him healthy. And I do think now defensively, I liked what I saw out of Pup Howard. I liked what I saw out of Gates. Jason Marshall has a chance to be good. Had a disappointing year last year.
But it's in there.
But it's in there, I think. Asa Turner, Jackson, I mean, he was like one of the first guys that caught Jackson's eye when we were watching warm-ups. And
he's a big physical safety.
He's
long-haired guy from Washington.
Transferred from Washington, so obviously was playing in the national title game last year. But lengthwise, I mean, he looks like he's got NFL traits, and I thought he, you know, showed some good things out there. So I am encouraged by what I saw. I do think that they'll be better, and you know, we'll see if that leads to more wins. But and I'm not worried really about the special team. I've been very hard on him for the special teams. I'm not overly concerned in a spring game when 10 guys go out to kick an extra point. It cannot happen, though.
Right.
Just so we're clear, cannot happen in the regular season.
In the second hour of the program, we'll do a shout. I want you to shout out if you went to the Gator spring game, if you watched it, if you got a thought about it. What do you think about the Gators and what you saw in the spring game? If you were around it, we'll do that at about 5:20, 5:25. But when we come back, we got Hayes headlines. Listen, you give me a gorgeous day, you give me golf, you give me the Masters and headlines. Pretty good day is what that is.
Back got something going.
This is 1010XL and 92.5 FM.
The Frangie Show from the Harrell and Harrell Studio. Don't settle for less than you deserve.
Now hear this.
Here's 1010XL's new lineup.
We're sending you back to the future.
Buckle up.
Dan and Jeff in the morning. Mike and Tony 10 to noon. Mia, Lauren, and Taylor noon to 2. Joe, Matt, and Leon 2 to 4. Frank and Hayes 4 to 6. And Rick and Hacker in the evening.
We invite you now to listen.
Frank Frangie here. These days, it's hard to know which companies to trust. When it comes to banking, I trust South State Bank. South State truly values its customers, and they work hard to create meaningful, lasting relationships. I love going into my local branch. I see the same smiling faces I've seen for years. South State is the largest bank headquartered in Florida, so they're able to offer all the banking services you need. You can trust South State Bank. Banking forward. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet have just received a special allocation of new vehicles directly from the factory. Not 10, not 20, but hundreds of new vehicles with special savings that haven't been seen in years. Every new vehicle available in your favorite color and option as far as the eye can see. Plus, get our exclusive 20-year, 200,000-mile warranty with every new car purchase. Hurry to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville before the best deals are gone.
Frank Franzi here for Stanley Pools. There's a reason so many of my friends and our listeners have had Stanley Pools build their pools and now maintain their pools, because Stanley Pools truly cares about their customers. Stanley Pools is locally owned and has been serving our community for 35 years. For all of your pool needs, call Stanley Pools at 269-7277. That's Stanley Pools, a family tradition of fine swimming pools. 269-7277, or find them online at stanleypoolsfl.com.
Have you been dreaming of enhancing your living space with top-quality custom windows and doors? Well, now's the 30-day spring sale with Renewal by Anderson. Save $300 on every window, $825 on all patio doors. Plus, no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Renewal by Anderson, a better way to a better window. Visit rbafla.com.
License number CGC1527613.
Hey everybody, Mike Dempsey here for Dandy Foods. Dandy subs and sandwiches, look, we always want you to think about those great options as you're driving around Duval. But the beauty is, even as I'm dropping pounds, Dandy's got great options for me as well. Told you all about their protein packs, delicious salads that they have out there. They have fruit cups for on the go. You know what they have, veggie snack trays. You can grab those on the go as well. Perfect healthy snack. Dandy is the name to know when you're on the go. So stop into a Gate store anywhere around Duval and make yours a Dandy. And do it today.
Let's go!
Looking for a night of action without a big hit to your bankroll? This Saturday, April 20th at 7 o'clock in the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena, cheer on your Sharks as they go all in against the Las Vegas Nighthawks. See what I did there? With tickets as low as $15, you can't find this kind of family, affordable fun anywhere else. Call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com.
Let's go!
Decades night. Find that old members-only jacket or favorite flannel shirt. We're celebrating the 90s. What's your favorite decade?
Let's go!
Don't miss the fun this Saturday, April 20th at 7 o'clock in the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena. For tickets, call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com. That's tickets at 904-621-0700.
Let's go! Let's go!
He used
used to cover the Jags. Now he's a CBS Sports senior NFL writer.
Yeah, well, I believe you got everybody's attention.
He's Pete Prisco. Friday afternoons on The Frangie Show. Brought to you by Showtime Sports Cards and Collectibles on 1010XL.
Divorce, menonly.com. This is Kenny Lay of Kenny Lay & Associates. Our firm specializes in representing men in family law. That's all we do. That's our only focus. We can help with all of your family law needs, such as divorce, custody, alimony, and child support. For over a decade, we have helped thousands of men with these types of issues. We even have an appellate division ready to challenge a judge's ruling. If you need a family law attorney, go to divorcemenonly.com. Divorcemenonly.com. Offices, Jacksonville.
Beards Diamonds' most popular sale is back.
All wedding bands are buy one, get one free.
Plus, all stackables, all right-hand rings, all eternity bands, and more are buy one, get one free.
At the St. John's Town Center or at BeardsDiamonds.com.
Hey, sports fans, this is Hayes Carlion from MyBookie. Look, we've all been there before. A weekend trip to the casino canceled because real life came calling. Well, MyBookie's new and improved online casino is here to change the game. Dive into a truly realistic casino experience featuring the latest in slots, progressive jackpots, and live dealer action, all from the comfort of your own home. I love the live casino. The roulette is awesome. It's so easy and so much fun. Just go to MyBookie and click Live Casino at the top. You'll find live dealers ready to deal or spin just like you're at the casino. The MyBookie Casino provides a Las Vegas experience when the action is in your hands. Start at MyBookie today with a generous sign-up bonus using promo code 1010XL, and a revamped loyalty program ensures a host of exclusive VIP perks. So sign up and hit the casino with promo code 1010XL. The more you play, the more you win, only with MyBookie.
Tired of running out of hot water? It's probably time for a new water heater. Call Duck Duck Rooter, the plumbing pros who specialize in water heater installation and service, including tankless water heaters, gas, or electric. Call us today for service. DuckDuckRooter.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Gather round!
It's Hayes' Headlines, presented by Harrell & Harrell. Don't settle for less than you deserve. Hear all about it. Here's Hayes Carline.
Welcome back to the Frangie Show. Frank Frangie, J.J. LaSelva, I'm Hayes Carline with you. Thank you to our friends at Harrell & Harrell. You can give them a call at 251-1111. All right, Frank, the Jaguars going to wear throwbacks. Exciting news for the fans.
Oh, I love
season.
Throwbacks. I can't wait to see when and how and what. Yeah. But you hope it's the original teal jerseys with the black and gold trim, black, gold, and white trim.
Yeah.
The stripes along those pants, those black, gold, and I mean, don't you hope that?
Absolutely.
I loved my favorite Jaguar uniform was their first one. And they wore teal and white at home, and they wore white and white on the road. There were not black pants then. There was not a black shirt then. It was teal and white at home, white and white on the road. You didn't need 87 different combinations. And I loved it, and I still think that's what the great teams still do. The Packers don't have a bunch of combinations, okay?
Right.
The Steelers don't have a bunch of combinations. They have one whatever you call it, where they do something weird. All these teams do, but mostly they wear their stuff. I love the throwbacks. I can't wait to see what they look like.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. We talked about Scottie Scheffler's dominance. Let's get to another master storyline of note. Tiger makes the cut to make history with his 24th consecutive, but really tough weekend for Tiger Woods.
Yeah, Hayes, I think what – we don't want Tiger to forever be the guy we just feel sorry for.
Right.
We want Tiger to be the guy we remember how great he was. I think it's a great story of resilience and a great story of fortitude that he's trying to play out there, and good for him. He's doing the best he can, and who am I to tell him not to, nor do I feel that way. But we know Tiger is never going to be competitive again in these guys. I'm not sure he's going to be competitive on the Champions Tour because of how his body has been injured so much. I hope he is. So I think it's great that he was out there. But we now know, I think we can now say, and I've said this for a long time, but I think we can now say Tiger's not going to be competitive. He's not going to factor in any events anymore. So good for him. I think it's awesome that he tried. I really do. And I mean that sincerely. I think it's awesome. But I don't want him to be the guy that everybody feels sorry for. I hope it doesn't become that.
Yeah, one Masters legend that did say farewell this weekend was broadcaster Vern Lundquist, who's been calling action on the 16th hole for 40 years. Jim Nance with, I thought, a beautiful closing to the broadcast, honoring Vern Lundquist. A fantastic clip that JJ has for us.
Vern wrote a book back in 2018 called Play by Play. And the last line in the book that you wrote, Vern, I want to apply it to you. You said, thanks, to borrow a phrase, thanks for the memories. Your voice has been a beautiful instrument. Thank you for a wonderful soundtrack for all of our lives.
Thank you so much, Jim. My honor, my privilege.
Fantastic stuff there, and you could tell the emotion in Vern's voice. To me, he's on the Mount Rushmore for me personally. For me, it would be Summerall, Madden, Lundquist, and Tirico are the four that I think I enjoy the most.
And the beauty of Mount Rushmore is we're all entitled to our own, right?
Yeah.
And that's right. Vern Lundquist is the, because of the distinctness of his voice, the marvelous pacing of his voice. Even if at the end he got a few wrong here and there, the pacing, the distinctness, the warmth of his voice, I think he's the soundtrack for 16 at Augusta. He's the soundtrack, the everlasting soundtrack to Southeastern Conference football for people like you and me. And he's a gentle-spirited, good man, lives in Steamboat Springs, Colorado. His wife is his spotter. He's just a wonderful story in all of sports, the Masters most prominent among them. We'll miss the great Vern Lundquist.
No doubt about it. Frank, we talked about Florida's running backs and how well they looked in the orange and blue game. Give me your impressions of DJ Lagway from what you saw.
Yeah, it looks like to me DJ Lagway is going to be very good. Rough around the edges now. I think there is a polish to Graham Mertz, who has started 42 more college games than Lagway has. But I think Lagway's big and physical. I think he's going to be a playmaker. I think he will be very good. It reminds you a little bit of Tebow when you first saw him. A little bit of Cam Newton when you first saw him. Big physical guy that when he learns the other stuff, will be a very good player. So I like what I saw in Lagway. My guess is this year you do see him on third and short in some quarters, some RPO stuff. Why would you use Graham Mertz in RPO when you've got Lagway and you can keep Mertz from getting hurt? This is Graham Mertz's team, and it is very critical, very critical. But I think Lagway is going to be a good player. I saw nothing to change my mind on that.
Georgia had its spring game as well. The defense won the day, but Georgia really aired it out a lot. Do you think we'll see more of that this fall from the Bulldogs?
A little bit. You've got a big arm quarterback. Why not? But Georgia's still going to do what they do, and that means they're going to out-athlete everybody. And when you out-athlete everybody, everybody's got to be involved. So not just the quarterbacks and the receivers, but those great running backs. But, yeah, when you've got a big-armed guy who can throw it over the top and you know fast receivers, yeah, you showcase them. The good teams change their play calling based on their personnel. They don't change their scheme. They don't change their philosophy, but they change their play calling. And I think Georgia will do that with the big arm Carson back at the controls again for another year.
A couple big NFL deals today. The Colts gave defensive tackle DeForest Buckner a 2-year, $46 million extension. The Eagles, meanwhile, also keeping one of their own. Devonta Smith, the exciting receiver, 3 years, $75 million. So a couple big deals there in the NFL.
Yeah, Devonta Smith's a good player. In the era of the receiver, which is kind of where we are because we're in the era of the quarterback, being in the era of the quarterback is what puts us in the era of the receiver. He's a very good player for him. You know, DeForest Buckner has lasted longer than I might have thought as an impact player. He's a good player.
Yeah.
And, again, the South is going to be interesting because everybody in the South thinks they're going to make an impact. It'll be interesting to see if they do.
It's really become an unbelievably competitive division, really, in just 1 year. All right, JJ, we're going to get your opinion on this. The NBA playoffs are getting ready to start. The Magic will be the 5 seed in the East. They will play Cleveland. The Celtics and Thunder are the respective 1 seeds. And the play-in starts tomorrow. Lakers, Pelicans, Warriors, Kings. The East play-in is Wednesday with Heat, 76ers, and Hawks, Bulls. JJ, what kind of tournament are we going to see?
I hope it'll be exciting. I think the Lakers are in trouble if they have to play Denver first round. They're probably going to get bounced in 4 or 5 games. But I've heard people bring up the conspiracy that maybe they should throw the first play-in game. That way they have to play OKC instead. So I don't think they'll do that, but I would love to see it.
And Frank, just in a mere 3 months we'll be doing an NBA Finals loser Monday.
Yes, we will. And I look, I don't even follow the association anymore, but I've said this forever as someone who doesn't, is an estranged NBA fan. If the Celtics go deep, and the years the Lakers went deep, even if it was the COVID year where they all played in the same junior high gym or wherever the hell they were, there's some intrigue, and there is for me.
Yeah, absolutely, and it'll be. I hope the Magic get hot. They're the 5 seed. I hope they beat Cleveland, and
that'd be a lot of Celtics.
That'd be awesome. Major career milestone in baseball this weekend. JJ's got a clip for us.
The pitch to McCutchen. High fly ball to left. Going back is Marsh to the wall, and there it is. Andrew McCutchen, number 300, here in Philadelphia. His first of the season and a milestone moment for a Pirate great, Andrew McCutchen.
And the Pirates are in first place, right?
That was my friend Greg Brown on the call. Greg and I are friends. He's the play-by-play voice of the Pirates, and we text during seasons and talk play-by-play, and he's a wonderful play-by-play voice. Andrew McCutchen has 300 home runs. Here's a stat for you. Only players – hang on, listen to this, JJ. I got a lot of stuff I'm putting in here. Only players in Major League history with 2,000 hits, 400 doubles, 45 triples, 300 homers, 200 stolen bases, and an MVP.
Wow. That's
Hank
actually
Aaron.
It. Go ahead.
Okay, hang on. Here's the nine. Hank Aaron, Barry Bonds, George Brett, Andre Dawson, Reggie Jackson, Willie Mays, Frank Robinson, Larry Walker, and Andrew McCutchen.
Wow.
You truly got to be a five-tool player to do that.
Is
Andre Dawson in the Hall?
Yes.
All those guys are Hall of Famers.
Except for Bonds, who should be.
Who should be.
So eight out of nine are Hall of Famers. Seven out of nine are Hall of Famers. Bonds should be in, and McCutcheon's the other.
Is Andrew McCutchen a Hall of Famer, Frank?
I don't think so. The MVP helps. If baseball changes to where a lot of the guys who wouldn't have gotten in the past, the Larry Walkers of the world, start getting in, JJ, then I think he's a peripheral guy. But I, as much as I love Cutch, as much as I love the Pirates, Dave Parker's not in yet. Andrew McCutchen's a wonderful player. He wasn't Dave Parker.
Listen,
go ahead, JJ.
Larry Walker is in the Hall of Fame, and that's what I was going to say. They just started recently putting in these guys of, like, these very good guys. So, like, if Scott Rolen is a Hall of Famer, Andrew McCutchen better damn well be in the Hall of Fame.
Well, and, like, well, Harold Baines.
He's the one that we all call out because it happened before all this was happening. But if Larry Walker, to your point, if Larry Walker and Scott Rolen go in, then the Andrew McCutchens of the world have a chance, no question.
In college baseball, FSU sweeps Miami to move to 30-5.
Yeah, they're really good. FSU, despite what happened in the one bad weekend at Clemson, FSU is really good. Link Jarrett is one of the best coaches in the country. I said that. He went to Notre Dame when he should have had the FSU job, and Mike Martin Jr. had it. He made Notre Dame, who's never good, so good that they beat top-seeded Tennessee and went to Omaha. You knew the minute the FSU job came open, he'd be there in about an hour. He was there, and I told everybody, look out. And then they weren't very good last year. And then some of my Gator brethren said, well, you still think Link's good? And I said, yes, I do. What he's doing is he's cleaning out. He's cleaning out the guys that don't fit. He's cleaning out the guys that don't fit a culture. And wait till he gets his guys in. I didn't think it would be this soon, but I thought Link Jarrett would really win. He is a great baseball coach, and FSU baseball is in very good hands.
Absolutely. Florida, JU, and UNF all lost 2 out of 3 in their respective series. It was a world-class episode of Saturday Night Live this past weekend. JJ, with the clip.
Professor, is there a problem?
Yeah. There's a gentleman in your audience who looks strikingly similar to Beavis from the cartoon Beavis and Butthead. It's just a little distracting.
I'm not familiar with that cartoon, but would it help if he moved seats?
Yeah, that might be a good idea. It's the gentleman in the blue shirt and blonde pompadour.
Fantastic stuff. You got to see this skit. It's an all-timer.
Tell Ryan, people who it
Ryan
is.
Gosling plays Beavis, and then you got to just see it. It's more physical comedy, But it is sensational. So go check it out. Caitlin Clark was also on SNL.
And she was fantastic.
She was. She joined Weekend Update and had some good one-liners. And Kate McKinnon was back as well in a cameo with a sensational skit with Ryan Gosling as well. So three great ones. But the Beavis and Butthead one, you don't even need to know anything about Beavis and Butthead the cartoon to enjoy this skit. But it is fantastic. So check it out if you haven't seen it already. And in our final item, I guess this is the music equivalent of the Heidi game.
What are you doing, CBS? What are you doing?
Here we go.
Live from CBS 4, this is your news now.
What are they doing?
What are you doing?
They should the Columbia broadcast system should exist no more.
Unbelievable.
That was one of the worst moments in the history of television.
How do you have a live concert and not give yourself a couple extra minutes?
Well, let me tell you everything. For people that don't know, the way this happened, so CBS advertises Billy Joel from Madison Square Garden, the 100th show, the 100th straight seller. I got to see the show in Madison Square Garden. It was one of the best shows I've ever seen in my life. So they say it's live. Well, it wasn't live because did you see her when he goes, it's a pretty good crowd. Did you hear that part?
For a Thursday.
For a Thursday. That meant they, because that's what Billy does.
Right.
Whenever he sings this on a pretty good crowd for Saturday, he says whatever the night is. So you gave it away that it wasn't live. You were showing it on Sunday, so you lied. And then miraculously, as he's coming to the end of the concert, and playing Piano Man, and it was, and they went to news all over the country. I'm thinking, what are you doing? And here's the, did you watch it?
I did not.
The shame of it is, music, I love Billy Joel. It was fantastic. It was just like the real show. I was there. I mean, it was one of the best concerts, and the camera shots, the cuts, it was perfect, perfect, until they cut off Piano Man. What are you doing? Let me say this simply and respectfully. It's Piano Man! You don't cut off, you don't go to news on Piano Man. What were we doing? Shut down CBS. They cut off in Piano Man. Unbelievable. I can't believe, I was watching.
Yeah.
I threw something at the TV.
I
had already
you.
Tweeted how good it was. And then after my how good it was tweet, you can't have me tweet how good it was. And then cut off Piano Man. What do we do? CBS owes every living human a rebate. And I don't care if I pay for it. I want a rebate anyway.
Those are the headlines.
Oh, my goodness. I'm worked up. Hour two is next. Stay with us.
It's
you don't cut off Piano Man.
With the Frangie Show. From the Harrell and Harrell Studio. Don't settle for less than you deserve.
If you need an insurance agent, I'll recommend the best guy in town, State Farm agent Craig Dewhurst. Call him at 940-9740. Really good guy, really good agent. Life insurance, homeowners, automotive, you name it, he'll handle it for you. Tell him what you need. He'll assess your whole situation. What kind of coverage do you need? How much coverage? What should your deductible be? What do you make and how does it fit your cost and your rates? You will love dealing with Craig, what a nice guy he is and how he'll help you get the right answers. The best in the business. Craig Dewhurst from State Farm, 940-9740.
Wonder what Rick Ballew would be doing if he wasn't on 1010XL?
Doing my job to the best of my ability on a daily basis.
Rick Ballew.
I work here.
Evenings.
I carry a badge.
On 1010XL.
Prosser here for Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. With the weather starting to turn for the better, look ahead. Get that backyard ready for spring with a new screened-in enclosure. Maximize the space you have and make it great with Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. They truly are best in the business. If you have the space and the idea, give them a call today. Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. Showroom just off Phillips Highway. Tell them Prosser sent you. Proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Tired of missing out on the conversation due to hearing loss? Hayes Carline here. At Jacksonville Hearing and Balance, their team of audiologists led by Dr. Douglas Green can help you rediscover the joy of connection. Jacksonville Hearing and Balance. Visit jhbi.org today.
Instant Keys. You don't have to go to the dealer. Instant Keys comes to you. For lost or broken keys or nearly any make and model of vehicle, call 722-1111 for Instant Keys Locksmith Service.
Rollin', 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 we're all callin' Rollin', the toy.
and goo just won't let that water through. You need Roland Reisch Plumbing by your side. When you have got a leak and you just can't wait a week, call 260-7059. Roland Reisch Plumbing.
Home of the Jacksonville Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
This is Hayes Carlion for Skylight Elite. Have you ever thought about aircraft ownership as another potential revenue stream and as a tool for tax savings? Put your tax money to work for you while enjoying the benefits of private personal travel. SkyLife Elite has over a decade of experience in business aviation and can guide you through the process with their expert staff. Call my friends over at SkyLife Elite at 490-9332 or find them at flyskylife.com to get the rundown on everything owning an airplane can do for you.
Everyone seems to be in a time crunch these days. Well, don't forget, you can always count on the cold case at Daly's. Always convenient, always cold. Whether it's the King of Beers, Natty Light, Stella, or Cigar City, a Goose Island or Bud Light Seltzer. Dash into Daly's and grab one to go.
I'm here with Clayton Bromberg of Underwood Jewelers. Clayton, why is it that when you look at how long a store has been in business, that it always seems to be the stores like Underwood's that sell fine quality that have been around the longest?
Frank, that's a question that really doesn't get asked a lot, but it should be. There are a number of reasons, but probably the biggest is because of the endorsements our longtime customers and their pieces of jewelry have given us through the years. You see, when you sell really fine quality jewelry, that piece will last longer and always stay beautiful. It might stay in the same family for generations, and through those years of wear, a lot of compliments will be made and a lot of people will be told where the piece of jewelry came from. You see, at a store like Underwood's, it's our stated goal to be the best jeweler in the South, not the biggest, so everything we do and carry has to help move us toward that goal. And ultimately, it's the satisfied customers wearing fine quality jewelry that have kept Underwood's in Jacksonville since 1928.
Underwood's in San Marco, Avondale, and the shops of Pontevedra.
Men suffering from ED or PE, you'll see instant results on your first visit at Prime Men's Medical Center. For a limited time, your initial consultation and first treatment are totally free. You'll even get a gift that enhances performance in the bedroom. Call 904-664-8217.
Hey everybody, it's Mike Dempsey here for Pella Windows and Doors. Look, obviously the warmer temperatures are already here. And if you're like me, you want that oppressive Florida heat to stay outside your house. That's why I'm such a fan of Pella Windows and Doors. By now we know that windows are the number one way that heat gets in and the cold gets out. So when you're ready for the stylish design and energy efficiency that comes from Pella Windows and Doors, visit their showroom on Phillips Highway, just north of Bay Meadows, or you can always find them online at PellaJax.com. That's Pella Windows and Doors.
If you owe the IRS and can't pay, now is the time to call J. David Tax Law. After a two-year hiatus, the IRS has resumed their aggressive collections letters. Don't wait. Call J. David Tax Law or visit jdavidtaxlaw.com.
This is your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update. I'm Andrew Gibson for 1010XL. This update brought to you by J. David Tax Law. It was a display of dominance by Scotty Scheffler on Sunday at Augusta.
His stardom confirmed.
Jim Nance with the call courtesy of CBS. Scheffler wins his second green jacket in the last 3 years.
It's hard to put into words how special this is. To be sitting here wearing this jacket again and getting to take it home is extremely special.
Scotty Scheffler joins Tiger Woods as the only other golfer to win the Players' Championship and the Masters in the same year. It's 87 degrees at 5 o'clock. Time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
Doors, please.
Time now for the SkyLife Elite Take Flight Moment of the Week. SkyLife Elite, North Florida's premier private air charter.
Beautiful line to start, Andrew.
Will it use that backstop? It's going to try. And it's going to get better. Scotty Scheffler spins a beauty at 14.
An incredible shot, one of many by Scottie Scheffler in total command. That was on 14, his approach to about a foot from the cup. He taps in for birdie to get to 10 under par. And Frank, from that point on, it was pretty much a coronation for now the two-time Masters champion, a richly deserved Take Flight moment of the week. Again, give our friends at SkyLife Elite a call at 490-9332. You can also find them at flyskylife.com.
Did you know they're like 10 minutes from here?
Yeah.
Like right around there.
If they are. We're
hills,
in their neighborhood.
Play golf, yeah. Go to Hidden Hills, go play 18, and then go fly somewhere in a charter.
Yeah.
They're that close.
Maybe next year for the Masters, we'll just
that's what we'll do.
Use them and we'll and fly then, up to Augusta.
And come back for the Guggen.
Yeah,
that's perfect. And we'll be right here. So
I like it.
They do a really good job. The point we always make about that, it is true. You can afford a charter flight. People don't think they can. It's more affordable than you think. So thanks to our friends at SkyLife Elite. Now, you're right about that. What Scottie Scheffler did is one of the most amazing things you'll see, and that is dominate on a tough day, on a tough week, on tough track, and obviously tough conditions when everybody expected him to do it. So it's really, really amazing stuff. So tip of the cap, certainly, to the great Scottie Scheffler. And the question now becomes, how far does he go? The question, is he going to win the other majors? Is he going to win the PGA? Is he going to win the U.S. Open? Is he going to win the Open Championship? Is this just going to – I'll say this. You can never predict. You can never assume – you can predict. You can never assume someone's going to win this or that. But this is – I said this at the top of the program, Hayes. He is as close to Tiger in this category of you expect him to win and he does. I can't remember any when Dustin Johnson was hot, when Jordan Spieth was hot, when JT was hot. They were all good, and you always knew when Rory was hot. You always knew they had a chance to win. But you didn't expect them to win the way you expect Scheffler to win. Does that make sense?
It does.
You expect Scheffler. When Tiger teed it up in the heyday, I expected him to win, okay? When Spieth and Rory and JT and Dustin Johnson were in their heyday, I thought there was a pretty good chance they could win. But I won't go as far as say I expected them to win so much that I'd be surprised if they didn't. When Tiger was in his stretch, I would be surprised when he didn't win. And I feel that way really right now about Scottie Scheffler.
I think the environment in golf has also really helped Scheffler out. He's obviously playing at an incredible level, but you know, again, this was a storyline going into the Masters, and I think it played out. The superstars are really struggling. I mean, we thought Victor Hovland would have a tremendous 2024. He did not play well this week at Augusta. Rory McIlroy, Brooks Koepka, John Rahm have fallen off, I would say. The guys that did contend, that gave Scheffler something to at least think about, Max Homa's yet to really do it. Colin Morikawa is working his way back after winning two majors in incredibly quick fashion. Oberg, I think, is the real deal. Ludvig Oberg, I'm impressed with what I see. He has gotten a ton of hype, and obviously watching him over the weekend, certainly he looks like somebody that is going to be in real prime position to make a big run at joining the elite. But it just doesn't feel like of the other superstars. Justin Thomas is still trying to find his way. Jordan Spieth is just maddeningly inconsistent. It feels like when you look at the scope of the stars in golf, it's Scheffler, and then a whole bunch of superstars that are in massive slumps.
Yeah, and it's amazing that he is the one guy that has so avoided that. He has so avoided the slump. And again, he is steady. He's not a grandstander. He's very spiritual, but it's not an in your face spirituality. This is kind of who I am, and you're asking me what my identity is, so I'm going to tell you. This what happens when a guy becomes great is people start digging harder. Not necessarily for the negative, but start digging. Tell me more about you. Let's learn more about his childhood. Let's learn more about his family. Who are you? What is his identity? Well, that's going to start happening now. It already has. But it's now with another Masters, it's going to get heightened. And that's good, by the way. That's not a bad thing. But we're going to learn more about Scottie Scheffler. And because of that, Hayes, he's going to have to do more and know more and talk more about who he is, not just about how he got it up and down on number eight.
Yeah, and I do think there'll be some pressure on Scheffler to now go win a U.S. Open, a PGA, or a British, to win it a major at a different venue. Again, and this was brought up during the week, he only has one major. Now he has two at the same venue. Again, there will be some things that he still obviously has to go out and do. But what would you bet against him? I mean, these majors aren't 4 months away. I mean, he's 3 weeks away from playing the PGA. He's basically 2 months away from the U.S. Open. He's 3 months away from the British Open. It's doubtful in the next 100 days that he's going to fall apart. So, and it's much more likely that the guys that are struggling are not going to find their form to beat him in the next 100 days. So that's the thing. I mean, you start the season with a win. Obviously, he had won prior to the Players this season, but you come in and win the Players and the Masters. I mean, it is really
pretty amazing.
It is absolutely amazing, and it's the genesis of what could really be one of the greatest seasons that we've seen since Tiger Woods.
Well, yeah, and in fact, one more major. If he wins one of the three, he then will have two majors in the Players, and after last year's year two. So it's pretty amazing what he can do. So we'll certainly talk more about that.
I saw somewhere where he's already made in career earnings, he'd be sixth, I think, all time.
Is that right?
It's incredible.
Wow. Yeah, he's certainly amazing, no question about it. All right, we are going to have a shout in just a minute. What did you think of the Gator Spring game? Hayes was there. We'll kind of reset his thoughts a little bit. Do you feel differently about Florida? Do you think it was just all a mirage and just because they look good because they're playing against themselves who aren't very good and you still think they're not going to be very good? Let us know that if you think they're going to be better than advertised. If somebody caught your eye, either watching it on the ESPN Plus or there, your thoughts about Gator football after the spring game, that's going to be our shout in a minute. Before we do that, though, you touched on a great job on the headlines, by the way.
Thank you.
Including the Billy Joel debacle, which is amazing to me. But did you watch Caitlin Clark in the weekend update with Michael Che?
Yeah, it was good.
It was really funny.
Yeah.
It was really, because I didn't realize that he rags on women's basketball.
Oh, when they pulled out the receipts,
they
it was
were
so
really,
funny.
The one he really said, the one that got me laughing the most is when he said the Iowa, whichever basketball game, set the record for viewers
with 14.2 million.
It beat the previous record by 14.2 million.
Right.
That was really fun.
Yeah.
But she was funny.
She was.
They wrote funny lines for her.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, it was really, he was a good sport about it, but it was really funny. It was you know what? She's great. She is great. I don't watch the WNBA either, but I think she's funny. I think she doesn't take herself too seriously. Well, I do wonder, now that she's not going to be playing college basketball anymore, does she disappear from the limelight? What do you think about that?
She's going to have to be electric in the WNBA. Like, she's going to have to be Bird Jordan-esque, I think, for people for the majority of the casual fan to keep up with and watch what the Indiana Fever, right, are doing. So I think she's going to have to be extraordinary.
Because
I think for people the casual ones to continue to follow. Obviously, her diehard fans are going to follow
until she's. But I mean this great mainstream following she has now, because I don't know.
I think in 2 years most people are probably there will be some fading in their minds of Caitlin Clark.
Yeah, because
I just don't think her professional.
Well,
I don't think there's a great professional place for her.
Yeah. Well, and the question is she a better basket? And I don't know this. I don't follow it. But is she a better basketball player than Lisa Leslie and Brittany Griner and Dawn Staley and Maya Clark? Is she better than they were? Because I don't know. So I'm talking from a position of ignorance, and I will admit to that. But they are regarded as the greatest players in the history of the sport. Is she as good as the greatest players in the history of the sport? If she is, then maybe. Because she's got a head start in terms of the mainstream populace. To your point, hey, she'd have to be that for that to continue.
Well, the other thing, too, is I'm assuming the Indiana Fever are terrible.
Yeah.
Since they have the top pick.
Right.
So, again, I would imagine that if you're a professional defender going against her, you just don't let her shoot from 30 feet and stay up tight on her the whole time. And so it'll be interesting to see if she's able to counter that. And maybe, I hope she's great. But I do think it's going to be hard for her to keep her star level where it is now
on a lousy team
when she's 2 or 3 years into a WNBA career.
JJ, and correct me if I'm way wrong on this, but I don't think that I am. There was so much to do about Wemby before he got to the association, okay? But JJ, at least for me, since he went to such a terrible team, that has faded a little bit. Not how good he is, not how great he'll be, not the way a 7'6" guy, whatever he is, 7'4", can do. The guard, right. But I think it's died down once he went to a team that lost most of their game. Did you sense that or no?
Since I'm like a follower of the NBA, it actually like picked up the last couple months. He was playing like insane. Like he was showing what everyone expected. But I agree with you. Like national media, I guess, he wasn't the topic of every conversation. Like you sort of expected when you heard a 6 or 7'7" like center who can shoot threes is coming into the league. But yeah, give it a year or so, he makes the playoffs, I think things will change.
Yeah, I'm not an NBA fan, but I'm way more intrigued by Celtics Nuggets if we get there than I am anything Wemby did.
Oh, of
you know
course.
What I mean?
Absolutely.
I'm a bystander. You know, I mean, I don't follow it, but that does have me some intrigue. So we'll see. All right, we're gonna do a shout right now. I'm gonna shout out. We need the best shouter of the day. Gets a custom shout T-shirt. By the way, I saw Papa G was out here working. Our first winner.
He said, awesome.
He was very proud of being the first winner of the shout, and he was out here working the tournament for Jacko. So we appreciate that. But your question is,
was he wearing the shirt?
He was not. And
well,
I had,
it's probably because it's encased on his wall.
I would hope. Yeah. I would hope. He did not ask me to sign it. Okay. So that never happened. So, yeah. And I did not have a Sharpie had he done that. When we come back, we want you to weigh in. 641-1010. You'll have 20 seconds to shout out what you thought about the Gator spring game, what you think about the Florida football team, good, bad, or indifferent. That is after this on 1010 XL and 92.5 FM.
The Frangie Show from the Harrell and Harrell Studio. Don't settle for less than you deserve.
Believe in the unbelievable.
Unbelievable!
1010XL.
I can't believe it! I can't believe it!
We're hearing is believing.
Unbelievable!
Folks, you tired of shopping those online dealers that overpromise and underdeliver? Are you ready to sell or looking for a deal? Well, you can find your next used vehicle at Nimnik Buick GMC with CarBravo, a better way to shop used vehicles online with transparent pricing. With CarBravo, Nimnik Buick GMC certifies all makes and models, Honda, Toyota, Kia, Mazda, Ford, all makes, all models. And buying a certified used vehicle has never felt better. Nimnik Buick GMC is proud to be named the number one CarBravo dealer in the Southeast region and top 10 in the country. That's one more reason to head to Nimnik for all your automotive needs. They got a great selection, hundreds of used cars, trucks, and SUVs to choose from. So head to Nimnik today and buy a car with CarBravo. That's Nimnik Buick GMC. Nimnik, your friends in the car business since 1941.
Are you thinking about upgrading your outdoor space with turf? Well, you'll love working with Caleb at Sunshine Turf. Genuine, always on time and trustworthy. Frank Frangie here. Look, we had Sunshine Turf design and install turf at the Bregan Baseball Complex. Man, it's gorgeous and it's maintenance-free. From putting greens to practice areas for kids' sports to pet runs to surrounding your pool, there's endless possibilities at Sunshine. So visit sunshineturf.info or give Caleb a call today at 904-892-0580 for Sunshine Turf.
I'm Holt Harrell with Harrell & Harrell. Choosing a law firm after an accident is an important decision. So how do you decide? With so many messages on air, I know it can all sound the same. At Harrell & Harrell, we believe what sets us apart is our commitment to you. When you've been injured in an accident, you need help from someone you know, someone you can trust. Harrell & Harrell, a name you know, a name you trust. Don't settle for less than you deserve. Offices, Jacksonville.
Do you have clicking, popping, swelling, or pain in your knee or shoulder? This can be due to arthritic changes in your joints.
Over time, you have wear and tear of your cartilage. I am Dr. George Bari, and here at Bari Orthopedics, we have numerous ways to treat your arthritis, such as regenerative medicine, including PRP, and joint replacements with CT guidance for accuracy down to the millimeter. If you are experiencing any of these symptoms, call us for an appointment today, or log on to BariOrthopedics.com.
Find out more at BariOrthopedics.com. That's B-A-H-R-I Orthopedics.com.
Brian and Angela Wall here with Window World. By now, everyone has heard about saving money on their energy bills. There are all sorts of things you can do to cut energy costs, but most people don't think about their windows.
But Window World knows that the biggest energy loss in almost every home is the windows. There is more energy loss from old builder-grade windows than just about anything else in your home.
You can upgrade your heating and air, your appliances, that's good too. But before you do all that, upgrade your windows to Window World's energy-efficient windows.
Window World's windows are easy to clean, energy-efficient, and have the best guarantee in the business.
Window World's slogan is simply the best for less, and we mean it. You get great American-made windows, and you get to keep more of your money when you buy from Window World. Need any more reasons to buy your windows from Window World? Call them today and set up your free in-home estimate, or go online to windowworldneflorida.com.
Window World, simply the best for less.
Thank you for your business.
Window World also offers energy-efficient doors.
I'm Taylor Rose with our Remedy Staffing Westside office off of Normandy Boulevard. We are helping great people find great jobs. Remedy has helped some of the best employers in Jacksonville find talented job seekers like you for over 25 years. Our current job openings range from entry-level distribution center pickers to equipment operators. Apply today at remedygoodjobs.com. Don't wait. Apply at remedygoodjobs.com now.
This is Hayes Carlion for Kingfish Pest Control. Are mosquitoes turning your outdoor fun into a full contact sport? It's time to call in Kingfish Pest Control. I can tell you from my own experience, they are the MVPs of mosquito elimination. Call Kingfish Pest Control today and get an unbeatable 50% off your first treatment. That's right, sign up for a full season of lockdown coverage and get 50% off your first treatment. Don't let mosquitoes steal your home field advantage. That's Kingfish Pest Control, proud partner of the Jaguars.
Weekends were made for sports, and I'll tell you my take on this weekend's best options. Pickett here. Watch for Weekend with Dan on YouTube and Facebook. Weekend with Dan is brought to you by Stone Core. We do outdoors better.
Hacker here, and I'm loving the doors that are now opening now that I'm down almost 50 pounds. Oh, yeah, and those results are in just 7 weeks with Awaken 180 weight loss. By doors, I mean opportunities I've avoided because of my weight, like an all-day adventure to SeaWorld or spending 3 days at Walt Disney World. Did I gain the normal 5 to 10 pounds I would have at Disney? Of course not. In fact, I lost 3 pounds. Last week at Disney, thanks to the good folks at Awaken 180. Awaken 180 travels with you, and I'm eating all sorts of foods, salmon, ground beef, broccoli, cabbage, collard greens, you name it. It's not a lie when I say I'm eating to lose weight is the only way to lose weight. Do what we all did, Matt, Mike, and myself. Call Awaken 180 Weight Loss, 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800, or go online, awaken180weightloss.com.
Toe 10XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
You know you make me wanna.
Time to shout.
Woo!
Looking for the best shouter of the day. But you have to do it in 20 seconds, so let's shout.
That's right. Let's shout. Today's topic is the Gator spring game and the Gator football team. What did you think? What do you think of them because of that spring game? If you were there, if you saw it on TV, or if you just follow in general, 641-1010 is the number. You have 20 seconds to tell us what you think. Let's kick it off with Bob W. Bob, you got 20 seconds.
Yes, I come down here 33 years ago, met my wife at a Florida Georgia game. And all I can say is I wish you would have been a Bulldog fan. Y'all have a good day.
Well, there you go. All right. If anybody wants to weigh in, the phones are kind of open for you. So now you're trying to win that custom T-shirt. Now would be the time to do it. Hayes, as we wait, did you sense there was energy in the stadium? It looked like it was. Even with the struggles of the team, it seemed like the momentum in the fan base is coming back. Did you feel? Did it feel that way?
Yeah, and again, I think the fans have been fantastic. Napier's first 2 years, they haven't performed as well as the fans want, but from the environment in the Swamp, it's been, I think, incredible. And it was good. We got there super early, and we were kind of low. So as it got into it, I looked up, and they had a really nice crowd. I think they estimated around 48,000, which sounds right to me. And and so I do think that there's an energy and excitement for some of the players on here. But there's obviously you have to be somewhat cautious because they've really been –
right,
I'd say subpar in his first 2 years, but it does look like it's a better roster. Certainly, he's got the experienced quarterback, and I'm curious to see what fans think about Lagway. How much should he really be playing this fall? I mean, I think he should have a role, and I think he will. But I'm curious to see how that goes in this fan base.
Let's go back to the phones, Joe. Gator football, you got 20 seconds. Go.
The sunshine that was the orange and blue game, there was the cloud. Once again, Gator program has trouble counting. They have a special teams with 10 players out on the field. Lagway looked good. Merch looked good. Got to get the small things together.
Joe, well said. Thank you for the call. And look, I'm with you, Hayes. I'm not too worried about it now in the spring. But I'll defend fans in this one a little bit. Because of what you saw last year, is why it alarms you to see it this year. That's a fair point from the fan base. Let's go back to the phones. John, you got 20 seconds. Go ahead, please.
Yeah, I think you said it best in your interview with Coach Spurrier. I mean, when 8-4 is something that he's getting excited about, we're in big trouble. But you know what? Duval, Jack, he's right around the corner, baby.
Yes, it is, John. Well said. Jack season is right around the corner, and I think there's probably a little more excitement in that fan base.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think 8-4 is kind of the number because, again, Florida can't afford to fire Billy Napier. They
right.
need it to work. They need it to work. They need him to get to the fourth year. And then you have to just hope that there's incremental progress and you're getting closer to being a consistent playoff team in the 12-team field and being at least somewhat competitive at the top of your league. So I think that's why no Gator fan is ever going to be completely satisfied with 8-4, obviously. And it's not going to be good enough, 2-3 years from now if he's still the coach. But I think what Florida fans are hoping for is with this schedule, if you can win 8 of these games, that's going to be 7 pretty good wins, and then you've got 1 cupcake win. So I think that's why the 8-4 is kind of the number. I don't think Florida fans have all of a sudden dropped their expectations
right.
for what they expect down, but that at least at 8-4, obviously he's going to get to the fourth year of his deal.
All right, if you got an opinion, we got a few open lines for you. We'll do it just for a few more minutes. We've got a number of calls. We'll pick between one of you, but we have some room for you now at 641-1010. If you want to try to win a custom T-shirt, tell me what you think of that Gator football team. Now is the time to do it. I will say this before we break on this, and I do believe this part too. Hayes, I do think that if they look more well-coached is what everybody said, not as dysfunctional, but more athletic. I've seen an awful lot of teams that can outrun bad schemes, that can outplay bad decisions. What they've got to do is be that. The one thing that made me feel a little better when watching the spring game, and I watched it on TV, I wasn't there, I sense there's more athletes. I sense there's more athletes in the secondary. I sense the linebackers run a little faster. I've said this before. I said it at the top of this program. To be good in college football, really any football, but college football, it's two things. It is quarterback play, and it is D-line. If you have those two things, and I think they have an advantage over a lot of teams because I think their quarterbacks are pretty good. I think their quarterback, Graham Mertz, not DJ Lagway, Graham Mertz is pretty good. And the third thing is overall general athleticism. If you have overall general athleticism, then you have a chance to be good too. Those are the three things. Quarterback one, D-line two, and then overall general athleticism, because that shows up on special teams and running game and the like.
Well, and feel free to not have to have like 13 true freshmen having to play significant roles. And that's really what it's been his first 2 years. Again, they were horrible defensively last year. And I'm not putting it all on these two guys. But when you're starting two true freshmen at safety,
right.
unless those players are Ed Reed and Troy Polamalu,
that's right.
you've got a heck of a problem. And this is the first team that he's going to have where I don't really get a sense that there is a true freshman that's going to have to be asked to play a really significant role. LJ McCray, I think, will be a rotational player, five-star defensive lineman. DJ Lagway, we know, is going to be, at best, a supplemental part of the offense. So I don't know that you're going to see. Maybe one of the linebackers has to play a significant amount, but it's not going to be near the amount of players it was in his first year and in his second year. So he also has an older team as well, and I also don't think he's playing as many guys out of position. I don't know that Damian George will be anything spectacular at guard, but I can tell you he's not a tackle.
Right.
Yet he had to play tackle for them last year. And so all those kind of things, I think, lead to some confidence that they can be a tougher out this year than what they've been.
And I'll say this. If you just find a modicum of confidence and momentum because of that, if you run a little faster, if you make a few more plays, again, down the stretch last year, they bought special teams and missed a field goal to beat Arkansas, and they allowed a 4th-and-17 and lost to Missouri. Everything in their season is different. They might have played FSU differently. Everything in their season is different if those two things not gone wrong. Now listen, that's the world we're in. Things go wrong. But everything would have been different or could have been different the way they're perceived. And Jaden Baugh and Jacoby Jackson and these new guys that we watched, Denson, the defensive back from around here who had the interception, I'm a big believer, and I do believe this, if Billy Napier lasts long enough to recruit another class like that, and that I think they're going to have a really good roster in years to come. Back in the day, you could be a winning coach by year 5 or 6. Danny Hurley went to UConn, and they weren't good at all for 2 or 3 years. But UConn said, we got to quit doing this. We don't want to be the school that's firing coaches every 2 or 3 years. Let's stay with this guy. And look what wound up happening. FSU was not very good in Mike Norvell's first 2 years, but nobody ever wanted to run him out. He won enough games to win, to stay. The biggest, the most damaging thing that can happen, lose to Miami or UCF at home, lose games you're not supposed to lose, look poorly coached, because you know what happens then? Big Gator 5220 goes on Twitter and says, we need to fire him. And you know what happens after that? All the Big Gator 5220 followers join in, and then everybody joins in, and then the media joins in, and then once it becomes that groundswell, it gets out of control and it's hard to contain.
There's not going to be any wiggle room in terms of, I think, how the fans view him and how the media views him. If they lose to Miami and they lose to UCF, I don't think he can recover. And it's, again, we've talked about how difficult the schedule is. The silver lining is the first half, I don't think, is all that hard.
Right.
And so if he can get some credibility in how the first half plays out, then I think he's got some leeway if he goes 2-3 in the final five.
Right.
If he's only lost once in the first half of the season, okay, well, then you've come in at 8-4. And you're going to a bowl game, and at least you've retained your job, and now you have a chance in year 4 to do something even bigger. So it's there, but he's got to get off to a fast start. If he loses 2 of those first 6 games, it's going to be awfully difficult for him to recover.
All right, I'm going to squeeze in 2 or 3 more of these calls. We're going to go quickly here. Let's go to Jared. Jared, you got 20 seconds. What do you think?
I just think Coach Armstrong, I think kids are getting tired of his antics, start hugging them and slapping them and jumping around. Won't he just coach them up for them to be successful? I saw one kid pull away out of his hug. I think kids are tired of that. They want the real deal.
Interesting stuff, Jared. Well said. Let's go to Dominic. Dominic, you got 20 seconds. Go ahead.
Okay, guys, I like the offense. Offense is going to be really good this year, fellas. Offense is really good. Defense is going to be a lot better. They're going to win more games. They're going to tackle. They're going to hit. They're going to get interceptions. Go Gators! Go Gators! We love you! Love you! Love you! Go Gators! Woo-hoo!
So there's that.
I think Dominic's won before, right?
Yeah, he
came close maybe before.
Yeah. I'm not sure Dominic sounded genuine.
Yeah.
That's my concern. Yeah. But it so there you go. All right, well done by our callers. We will pick one guy who had the shout of the day. That comes up in just a bit. We got one segment to go in the program. Back after this on 1010XL and 92.5 FM.
It's the ride home with the Frangie Show. From the Harrell & Harrell Studio, don't settle for less than you deserve.
This is Brent Musburger's Action Update, brought to you by Duck Duck Rooter Plumbing, Septic, and Air Conditioning, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Now, here are the latest lines from my guys in the desert.
The NBA will have its play-in tournament in the Western Conference on Tuesday night. The 7-8 matchup pits the New Orleans Pelicans against the LA Lakers. New Orleans, a one-point home underdog against the Lakers, minus 104 on the money line. The Lakers, minus 112, the over-under at 225. The 9-10 matchup with the loser going home pits Golden State against Sacramento. The Warriors, a two-and-a-half-point road favorite, minus 136 on the money line. The Kings, plus 118, with the over-under in Sacramento at 223.5. This update brought to you by Duck Duck Rooter Plumbing, Septic, and Air Conditioning, a proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars. I'm Tony Desiri with your VSiN Action Update on 1010XL.
Duck Duck Rooter is a full-service plumbing company that's locally owned and operated, fully licensed and insured. We'll be at your home in a timely manner, provide honest pricing, and ensure the job is completed correctly, or we'll make it right. Duck Duck Rooter can handle all plumbing jobs, including repairing broken pipes, clearing clogged drains, to installing new fixtures, water heaters, garbage disposals, and full repipes for older homes. If you're stuck, call the Duck, 904-862-6769. That's 904-862-6769.
Hey sports fans, this is Hayes Carlion from MyBookie. Look, we've all been there before. A weekend trip to the casino canceled because real life came calling. Well, MyBookie's new and improved online casino is here to change the game. Dive into a truly realistic casino experience featuring the latest in slots, progressive jackpots, and live dealer action, all from the comfort of your own home. I love the live casino. The roulette is awesome. It's so easy and so much fun. Just go to MyBookie and click Live Casino at the top. You'll find live dealers ready to deal or spin just like you're at the casino. The MyBookie Casino provides a Las Vegas experience when the action is in your hands. Start at MyBookie today with a generous sign-up bonus using promo code 1010XL and a revamped loyalty program ensures a host of exclusive VIP perks. So sign up and hit the casino with promo code 1010XL. The more you play, the more you win. Only with MyBookie.
Let me get this thing unwrapped here.
Duval, Pros, what in the world are you doing working on your Duval?
That's right, man. I really identify with Duval.
You live in St. John's County, knucklehead.
I mean the Duval sub, the Daily's Dash Duval. Turkey, ham, melted cheddar, and habanero jack cheeses. Lettuce, tomato, crispy and fresh, you know, like me. I'm sure there's a Daily's Dash sub that sums you up.
The boss.
Because, of course,
oven roasted beef, Munster cheese, roasted mushrooms, caramelized onions. It's the boss of all subs. Only available for me.
That's just not true.
What do you mean? I walked in the other day, screamed, "You know it!" and said, "A boss for a boss."
Well, no matter who you are, there is a Daily's Dash sandwich or sub for you.
Go find yours. They may even make you a boss.
I'm sure they will, because it is Daily's Dash.
Where more is better.
And you got that right.
This is former NFL quarterback David Garrard. If your knees have taken a beating and you're finally ready to do something about it, then let Southeast Orthopedic take a look. Come on, do your knees a favor.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
David Garrard here. I've had the PRP treatment from Southeast Orthopedic Specialists and my knees are really doing well. Platelet-rich plasma treatment may be the answer for whatever is hurting you.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
Exciting news from All Pro Roofing. Effective right now, you can get an instant roof quote. Just click the instant roof quote tab on their website. Whether you're in need of roofing, exterior siding, or windows, All Pro Roofing is your local partner for quality craftsmanship. Click the instant roof tab and voila, get an instant quote. It's that simple. Click on the instant roof quote tab today at allproroofingllc.com.
License number CCC 132706.
CDC 060138.
You know, they say April showers bring May flowers, but about nigh, they're bringing more than just blooms this April. Pick and here, gang. It's time to spring into action and refresh your vision for the brighter days ahead. Don't let cloudy vision rain on your parade. From dry eyes and allergies causing irritation to cataracts blurring your vision, Bowden Eye can help protect what's important to you. If you're experiencing problems with your vision, call or visit BowdenEye.com to schedule your consultation. Bowden Eye & Associates, keeping the First Coast focused.
I'm Hacker. Get more Gators on the Gator Bites podcast presented by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists with new episodes every Wednesday. Subscribe and listen by searching for 1010XL Florida Gator Podcast on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher, or TuneIn.
Clearwater.
John, I can't even mow my side yard. It's so soggy. Man, my builder sucks.
Brent, calm down. This is a common problem in neighborhoods where houses are built too close together. You need gutters and a properly installed French drain that will soak up subsurface water. We can completely dry it up.
So I can take my builder off my speed dial now, huh?
Yeah, we got you, buddy. Let that builder bitterness go.
Clearwater Irrigation.
And drainage, too.
Big Brothers Big Sisters is teaming up with the NFL to inspire change. From now to draft day, Big Brothers Big Sisters is following the NFL draft, aiming to recruit potential bigs. Hi, I'm Brent from the 1010 sales team. I'm committed as a mentor, and we need you to step up and become a mentor too. There's a waiting list of more than 50 children hoping for a mentor. It's just a few hours a month. Be a mentor. Become a big. Visit bbbsnefl.org. Be a mentor or visit Big Brothers Big Sisters and click on Big Draft.
Does the building you go to work in every day need a little love and attention? Jason Parker here with Performance Painting. Great companies take great care of the buildings their staff and customers walk into every day. If the building you're in doesn't match the vision you have for your company, we can help. Go to performance-painting.com. Our highly trained team makes the difference. Quality coatings applied with pride.
Performance Painting!
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
It's a Best Bet Monday on The Frangie Show with fantastic locations in Jacksonville, Orange Park, and now in St. Augustine. It's Best Bet.
Frank Frangie, Hayes, Car Lion, J.J. LaSelva with you. I got breaking news.
All right.
The Columbia broadcast system has spoken.
Good.
This from CBS, quote.
They're giving every American $20?
Every American gets a rebate. I said that, and I'll stand by that. Instead, they're saying this, quote, a network programming timing error ended last night's Billy Joel special approximately 2 minutes early in the Eastern and Central time zones. We apologize to Mr. Joel, his fans, our affiliated stations, and our audience whose viewing experience was interrupted during the last song. Don't be afraid to name the song, but right. I digress. Due to the overwhelming demand from his legion of fans, Billy Joel, the 100th, live at Madison Square Garden, although it wasn't live because it was on a Thursday, will be rebroadcast in its entirety on CBS on April 19th. So this Friday... So if you're a Blue Bloods fan, you lose that. But okay, but you now get so they're going to be it, which I'm very happy about.
I think the only way that CBS,
I mean, they got killed as they should have,
can really make up for this egregious error is to give ESPN the SEC football song.
You know what? Now that I'd be okay. I still want the 20.
Yeah.
Okay, but I still want the $20 rebate.
Well, oh yeah.
But other than that, I think that would be. So anyway, they are going to replay it on Friday. One of the cool things, by the way, they showed during the show, and they didn't show him performing, the clips of all the people that came up on stage with him during this 100-show residency. Springsteen, Bon Jovi, Steve Miller, Mellencamp, Fogerty, Sting, Miley Cyrus. I mean, you think, and yes, I just said Miley Cyrus in the same breath as those others, but you get the point.
Yeah.
The big stars.
Well, she's a huge star today.
She is a huge star, yeah. No question. But all the and other stars that I don't remember, they mentioned some others. But the point is, during this residency, they would just pop up and sing. Well, last night Seinfeld was on the residency thing because he gave him they awarded him something for the 100th.
Cool.
So Seinfeld came out because he's as New York as anybody.
Yeah.
So it was really a cool show. I said this before and I tweeted it. When Suzanne, I've seen Billy Joel 10, 12 times, whatever, all over, more here than anywhere else. But when we saw him in Madison Square Garden, it was a religious experience. It was different. The way he connected with the crowd was just different. And some of the fun things he did that he did again on the show last night, like an innocent man, he tells a great story. He's got to hit that really high. Well, he said, I can't hit it anymore. He said, so what's going to happen is in the middle of the song, there's a chance you're going to think I suck. Okay. Okay. But I'm just telling you this. So I'm saying that in advance that I don't hit the note. So then when the song's over, he did this live when we were there, and when the song's over, he goes, whoo, I hit it. You know, and people go crazy, you know. So, and as you can imagine, like all bands do, when he plays Piano Man, there's two or three verses he doesn't even sing. The whole. Now imagine 20,000 in the garden singing Piano Man. Now every band has that, but there's something different about the garden singing Piano Man back to Billy Joel than other people singing their songs back. You know, so it's a really cool thing. So it'll be fun to watch. And as you know,
it'd be hilarious if they messed it up again on Friday night.
It wouldn't be that hilarious. I'll fight somebody. But as you know, I'm going to see Suzanne and I are going to Chicago to see Billy Joel and Stevie Nicks. That should be a great show.
Absolutely.
I mean, that will be. Wow. There's two or three songs they do together, which will be really. I think they do Leather. And, you know, by the way, Stevie Nicks has more duets.
Right.
She had the duet with
Tom Petty.
Tom Petty, Don Henley, mm-hmm. Kenny Loggins had a bunch of them. You know, maybe it's the Pet. Don't Stop Dragging My Heart Around.
That's Petty.
I think that's the one they do together.
Okay.
I think that's the one Billy Joel and Stevie Nicks do together. They do two or three songs together. And that's one of the ones that I think that's the one they wind up doing together. So, hey, do want to congratulate John. John is our shouter of the day.
Well done, John.
You talk Gator football and you drop in a Duval.
Yeah, that's good.
That's a pretty good combo. Yeah. Okay, John, well thought out. So, John, you are our shouter of the day. And for that reason, you get a Shout T-shirt. So there you go. So congratulations to John. We have not taught draft today, mainly because we've taught draft every day for the last 80 days. But it's coming close. Any new thoughts, any different thoughts?
I mean, I think we're getting to the point of paralysis by analysis.
Yes.
I mean,
we always do this time of year.
As we always do, yeah. But, I think, could they trade up? Sure. I mean, hopefully, you know, they can maybe find a partner and trade back. But I think the biggest thing is one of the two corners there at 17. I think that's where it still is. Tarrion Arnold, Quinyon Mitchell. If one of those two players are there, I think it's pretty simple. I think that's the pick at 17. And I don't think both will be there. It would be fascinating if they were both there just to see which one they prefer. But I think it's a pretty simple draft, actually, for the Jaguars. I think it's corner, and then I think you look at receiver and edge from there, and then maybe in with those two fourth-rounders, you look at offensive tackle, defensive tackle.
And there's no – I don't sense, and I don't think you do either, that there's a surprise coming. They're not one of the. They're not the team that's going to trade for Brandon Ayuk, even though he asked for a trade or reportedly did. I don't think that's going to happen. I don't think there's a blockbuster up or down move for them. Do you agree with that? I think they're going to pick. I think they're going to have the 17th pick in the draft. I don't think they're going up or back. I don't think they're trading it away.
I wouldn't go up to 9 to get Odunze. If I could get to 6 and Harrison or Neighbors were there, I would certainly consider that, but I think that's far-fetched because I think those teams, if those players fall to those teams, why would you move back?
Right.
I mean, and so I think, yes, I think they, I would put it at 80% they stay at 17, 15% that they're able, they get lucky enough that somebody is willing to come up and they can drop to like 24 or 27 somewhere in there and pick up some additional draft capital. And then I put it at 5% that they move up in the draft. I think it's very, very likely they stay at 17. I think they're in good position. You know, if again, they also have to weigh it as if you really like receiver there, is Brian Thomas is going to be there. So do you like Brian Thomas enough just to say, well, we'll just stay here and take Brian Thomas.
Right.
If the two corners are gone. But I think it's – I get we have to keep talking about it. It's still a week from Thursday. But for me, it's a pretty simple place where they're at with this draft.
Yeah, I think so too. And again, what we don't know is how they value specific players. We have a pretty good idea where the positions of need are. We have a pretty good idea of where the positions of strength will meet positions of need for not just them, for other teams, and certainly them. But we don't know how much they value Tarrion Arnold versus the other corners or Brian Thomas versus some of the other receivers. That's what you never know about a team. You can guess all you want. You know, we nobody knew We knew they liked some offensive tackles. Nobody knew Anton Harrison, they had him that high. He was a guy we took. There were a lot of tackles last year, so nobody knew how high they had him. So you don't know that until the draft.
Well, even last year, I mean, it was a surprise that they addressed tight end in the second round and running back in the third round. So, yeah, I mean, obviously we don't know their specific board. And we, you know, as part of being fans, we watch mock drafts for months, and you sort of get it in your head – well, that it's just malpractice not to think Terry and Arnold's one of the best corners. They may not. I mean, you just don't know. There are so many nuances to this, and there's so much more information the clubs have compared to what we have. The interactions they've had with these players, the interviews that they've had with them, the in-person visits that they've had. So it's a complete guessing game in terms of what specific clubs like about each prospect.
That'll do it for our program. Thanks for being part of it, folks. We are out of here. Do want to thank our friends from Hidden Hills for having us out. The Googan was a blast today on a gorgeous day here at the Hidden Hills Country Club. The Googan was a blast. We're out of here. Don't go anywhere, though. Rick Ballew is out here, and he's next. For Hayes and JJ, I'm Frank Frangie. So long.